divisional seller and divisional buyer angle, what is the minimum practical transfer price and the maximum you will push it, you will agree to? Think about selling from the seller's angle, think and tell me what's the minimum you will be willing to sell at. Think about the buying angle and tell me what's the maximum you will be willing to pay. So, minimum?
At cost.
At cost. Maru.
Very good performance management, management accounting students. Like cost kyu hua hama? Mama hi taara hama cost kari.
Cost
at what
the first one bought? The buyer bought it.
What if the buyer made it? What if the seller is making? Not.
Sorry,
yeah. What if he's making? He didn't buy it, he made it.
So there's the cost that he incurred in making it.
What do you call that? Cost of making it.
Cost, production cost.
Yeah, production cost. Okay. Looks about. It's production cost, management accounting terms. But in addition, I'll ask you, is it production cost? Is it fixed production cost? Is it variable production cost? Is it prime cost? Is it total cost? Is it total actual cost? Is it total budgeted cost? What cost? Is it standard cost? Yeah, wo costing kya hum kya cost kar lage? What cost?
Total cost. What else?
So why is
it
total cost?
Why don't you help us?
I suppose prime cost plus fixed. Yeah, fixed overheads plus variable overheads.
Oh, you forgot one thing, huh?
Minimum.
Minimum.
Standard cost. Minimum you are willing to pay. Think of this, okay? Think like this. I'll give you a situation. You are a phone manufacturer, right? So, phone manufacturer, you are building the IC. Internal division, you are the IC division. You are sending it to the assembly division, right? Production cost is, variable production cost is $20. Fixed variable overheads is $30. Fixed overhead is per OAR per unit is $5. So your total cost is 20, 30, 40, 45. What is the now? There is a cost structure, then you will add a profit margin to this. Now you are selling this IC to assembly, internal division. What is the minimum you will be willing to accept? Now I am the IC division, I am the assembly division. I am telling you, I'll pay you $20. Happy? Will you agree? Okay, I will pay you $25. How about 25? Can we do this? 25? No? Okay, how much do you want? Minimum? Yeah, I don't have a lot of money. I'm a new business, I just took over the business 5 days ago. What is the minimum you are expecting? Tell me. Here.
45.
You want? They're very dangerous. Can't do business like this.
30?
Sure. We'll do a 30. 30, everybody in agreement, everybody has to agree. Nah, wait, obviously you okay, sir.
Total cost is 55 now? Yeah,
okay, 55. Sorry, my bad. 15? 50. 50? How about 50? Huh?
logically, for every IC you manufacture, you spend how much? Per IC, how much do you spend? Is it 55 or 50? Why
55?
See, it's per unit, no, fixed overhead is, you are dividing it by the number of units. No?
Yeah.
Fixed overhead is like rent. Whether you manufacture 2 units or 20,000 units, you will have to incur this 5. It's just 5 here because the number you divided, the volume you divided it by is a particular figure that gives you 5. OAR, overhead absorption rate. But for every unit you manufacture, your incremental cost per unit is how much? 50. So at the minimum, you want to recover that, no? You agree? Head office selling
illa
kanna
rent. But then the fixed cost also, you're definitely going to incur.
Yes.
So don't you have to put that?
No. See, at least the minimum. That's the question. The minimum. Okay? Now, say, This department is in one area and the rent is 200k. Okay, so out of the rent, you look at the portion for the IC division, it's 50k. Right, out of the 50k, IC division manufactures 10,000 units. Right, so 50,000 divided by 10,000 is $5 per unit rent. Let's say that this rent is that rent figure, but whom the person who might be paying this might be the head office, because it's their premises, they have to pay it. It's a central operation, central cost. You're just charging it to the division. What you learn in absorption costing, where I take a absorption basis for the charge curve, but you give one head office in vendor block. But since you're using up that space, they charge it. So I'm not saying it's not a valid cost. I'm saying at the bare minimum, I will expect 50. I will not accept a single dollar less than 50. If I can, I will push for 55 now. I agree. Right? Oh, me release again in the Amnikat Tekka Adelema, Homotran Deva, Abhi Godin Mis. Right? May Oka Won. Right? But the minimum is 50, because for every unit I manufacture, I have to spend $50. So, see, when it comes to the range, the potential and practical range, the minimum possible cost is variable or marginal cost. Now think of the angle of a seller. Sorry, not the seller, buyer. You're buying. If you're buying, okay, what is the maximum you're willing to pay? Actually, take good money, whatever angle you think you can tell me.
Market price.
Maximum is market price. Straightforward, because nobody is going to pay you more than the market price. Right? Let's say this IC or whatever, this port. Or this let's say the phone is LE, I can get it for 200k. Internal bugger is coming and telling me, give me 300k. You'll be like, no, sir, you're paying on money. Right? Because come on, I can get it outside. So, whatever price you can get it from the external market, external market price. This is what the maximum possible transfer price is. So, subheading, range of a transfer price, minimum is the variable or marginal cost, maximum is the external market price. Okay. Can you do this example? A subheading, determining the market price, sorry, transfer price. Determining the transfer price. Example 1.
We have one option, 53.
in skills development said the minimum.
No, it's not the minimum. This is the range. It can be anything between this. Okay? It can be any price between this. This is the range. But it won't ever be less than the variable cost, and it will never be more than market price. Maybe D and J, two divisions, D sells internally and externally. Variable is 45. External is 80. Okay, now let's say I am D. No, you are D. Let's say you guys are D. Right? I am J. I am buying from you. Actually, this doesn't work like that. I'll be D. Okay? I'll be D. Variable cost excluding cost component, J, 20, external selling price is 80. I have a production capacity of 30,000. So, I can manufacture 30,000. I can either sell it outside for 80, or I can sell it inside to you. All component manufacturers in the industry sell the component for $80 each. If J is to buy all the components from D, what should be the transfer price per component? Now, what's your price? 53, no? I'm pitching 53. You are the buyer. You're the buyer. Are you guys okay? Are you okay to buy this at 53? Is it a good deal? If you are buying from outside, how much do you have to pay? 80. Then obviously this is a good deal. Now think about me, my situation. Yako, LEA, I can sell it for 80. Why the hell would I sell it to you at 53? What do you think? What benefit does it bring the company? Is the company making anything if I sell you at 53? No, I can sell it outside and bring an additional profit of how much? It's not additional. I can make a profit. On the 53, I can make a profit as a selling division. Why would I sell to you at 53? You either give me 80, we'll do this deal. If you can't pay me 80, for the company, I'm thinking from the company's view. Earlier, there are people who are ready to buy for 80. That is the price. Okay. But see, the submitting you took down is determining the market price, transfer price. See, that is why I gave you that under this example is because, guys, transfer price, the logic behind transfer pricing is always, this is how it works. It's the marginal cost plus the opportunity cost. It's always, this is the primary logic behind determining any transfer price. Right? Let's look at this. Let's say, right, in this situation, what is my marginal cost? 45. For every unit I sell inside at 45, think, right, for every unit I'm selling you are. LEA, I'm losing each customer. I'm losing an opportunity to sell it at 80. So what's the opportunity cost there of selling to you at 45 and not selling to an external customer at 80? It is 35. In other words, in this case, it's the contribution per unit. For every unit I'm transferring internally, I'm losing the contribution of 35. The opportunity cost is market price minus variable cost, which is 80 minus 35, or rather 45. 80 minus 45 is how much? 35. 35 plus 45 is ultimately 80. So don't think that the 80 is coming directly from the 80 market price. No, that's not how it works. in determining the transfer price, how it works is, it's the marginal cost plus any opportunity cost. Always use that logic. I know that you guys, when you learn transfer pricing, you will learn formulas in there. If there is a surplus capacity, if there is a perfect market, remember, for you draw different scenarios and you come up with different formulas. You don't need the basic logic behind any transfer price is this. It's the marginal cost plus any opportunity you are losing. If the opportunity cost is zero, then you can sell it at what? Marginal cost. Now here, why is that opportunity there? Because your external demand is what? This is the fact that decides your opportunity cost. You have an unlimited external demand. You don't have to be certain when the internal demand. You have a readily available market. They are ready to pay you. So this company will definitely, if you are the company, this is D, this is J. From the company perspective, selling to outside party at 80 is more profitable, is definitely a lucrative deal than 45. Right? So since there are customers at 80, willing to pay 80, if you are doing this, you will do at 80, or else you will sell it outside. That is as the selling manager, selling divisions manager. Are we clear? Then put this down and highlight this, the logic. This is how you determine transfer price orders. Do this example for example 2. Is there an opportunity? There is no opportunity. Right? So it's what? 45 plus 0 in this case. Because there is nobody, if you are not going to pay, not going to sell it internally, you'll have to dump it. Because there is nobody to buy. The only option you have is what? Selling internally. So if I'm the seller, if I'm the buyer and I know this, if I know that there is no external demand, I will successfully negotiate a 45 price.
If annual demand is 15,000,
then different seller. Yeah, annual demand is 0. Okay. So this is here 45 plus 0, 45. Now example 3. Now it's a page breaker, so don't mind it. D and J are two divisions. There's the information. There are conditions. Transfer price is to be set at the opportunity cost. As standard, J should buy all from D. D should first satisfy J's requirement, then only sell to the external market. There are 4 requirements. 1, 2, 3, and 4. What are the requirements? If D's external demand is, so I want the transfer pricing policy that you will set, if the external demand is 20,000. If it's 25, if it's 40, and if it's 50. 4 sets of answers.
When they mention the transfer price is to be set at opportunity cost, they're not considering the variable cost at all?
No, it is. It is. Even the marginal cost is portion of the opportunity cost. You need to get that money. What they mean here is this transfer price is marginal cost plus any opportunity. That's what they mean. You have a 50,000 capacity. J should buy all 30 from D. So D is the seller, you get it from like this. Requirement A, like this, D is selling. D can sell to J and external market. We'll show both the views. How many at what price? That's the question. And here, this is where the transfer price comes in. So, right, I can manufacture 50. Out of that, J will always get 30K. J has to get all of it from there. So this is fixed, 30K.
At what price? That's the question. Right. Externally, if I sell 30k here, external it will be 20k. At what price? That's standard. At 8. That's the external market price. This is the external. So here, requirement A. What should be the transfer price per components if this external demand is 20,000? So then, if it's 20,000, I sell 20, sorry, first I sell 30, I transfer 30 for J. Balance 20 external. External I sell for 80, no problem there. Am I losing any opportunity after that? No opportunity cost, therefore 30,000 and 40. Fine. Done? Go. Requirement B. What is it? 25,000. So now external demand is 25,000. Demand is 25, but so sales is, you will sell 20k at 80. Demand is 25. So then, the fact that I'm selling 20, what's the opportunity? I'm losing 5,000. So my deal is this. Out of the 30, 25k, let's do it at 40. Okay. Out of the 30,000 I transfer internally, 25k will do it at 45. But the balance 5k is an opportunity that I'm losing because I'm selling to you. Those, that 5k, you give me 8. Okay.
So you don't have to
give
an average price,
right? The total amount is this into this plus, this into this, that will be the total bulk price. Then you can finish off C and D easily. Requirement C. External demand is 40k, but sales opportunity is 20k. Therefore, opportunity loss is 20k. So what I'll do is, right, I have to transfer 30 now. Out of the 30, 10k I'll sell at 45. The 20k opportunity I'm losing, you're paying me 80. So requirement D, external demand is 50k, sales opportunity is only 20k because you have to prioritize J. To J you sell, therefore, to J you sell 30k, out of the 30, opportunity loss is how much? 30k, no? So then, no, sorry, can do 30k at 80. So. So those are the two ranges, you know. Minimum, maximum, anything in between. By all means, please access your shared folder. There are so many practice questions. You can use it as recap. It's not as simple as the examples you've done. Transfer pricing can get tricky as they complicate different scenarios, you know, and how it works. But as long as you understand that fundamental logic, marginal cost plus opportunity cost, everything works.
Will you be requested to calculate?
Very unlikely. You will be requested, nobody is requesting anything much in the paper. But One requirement is they might have transfer prices. You might have to evaluate them and say whether this is the ideal price or not. Right? I have an example also. I'll show you today. The kind of the way how the examiner tests transfer prices. We'll look at it now. Before which, write down basis of setting up transfer prices. Basis of setting up transfer prices. How it works is, now we know the range to variable cost to market price. Between this, anything goes. Right? That's the first thing to remember. Depending on within this range, there is cost based transfer price. Okay? So it starts with this. You can have variable cost. You can have variable cost plus a profit. You can have total cost. You can have total cost plus a particular profit. Anything. But these kind of setting up, these kind of methods that you set up transfer price, we call this cost based transfer prices. Another is market price, which is the high, right? So you call it market price based transfer price. There is another called two part tariff. Two part tariff. Here what happens is you transfer at cost, right? It could be, depending on the scenario, it could be marginal cost or total cost. And later, usually at the end of the period, settle a lump sum to cover the fixed cost. Exactly. We may cost take a karamu, but end of the period, one fixed take a cover karaganda gaat din. And you call it two part tariff. That's the name of the technique. Right? Two part tariff. That's all that also happens generally. Fourth one, and there's another one called dual pricing. In dual pricing, what happens is, what is the advantageous price to the seller to sell? To the seller, what is the best price in the range? So seller records at market price. So seller's P&L is nice, well done. Okay. The buyer, what is the ideal price for the buyer to buy it in turn? Buyer, if you're buying, you would like to get it at variable cost. So the buyer records that variable cost. Now, do you think the accounts will balance if you do it like this? No, right? Consolidation you do, right? IAS 5, interdivisional trading, intercompany trading. Remember, right? So it has to balance. In that sense, what happens is, the head office, when consolidating, adjusts for the balance. Central. Transfer pricing adjustment, yeah, balance. This method ensures that the divisional P&Ls show optimum levels. But end of the day, the company profits are unaffected. Right, transfer pricing is only something that directly affects the divisional P&L, not the company P&L, unless your divisions are in different tax regimes where you can try and get some tax benefits. So other than that, this is called dual pricing. These are very basic explanations, but the logic is this. Are we clear?
clear? You have cost base, from variable cost to adding different profit margins, markups. You can, the entire range is here. If your total cost is this, and total cost plus profit is this, you have the entire spectrum. Starting from variable cost, any price goes. So long as the two divisional managers agree. You can have a deal with the other divisional manager. Then market price, two-part tariff. You transfer at cost and later settle a lump sum. And the fourth one is dual pricing. Take this up. Complete this.